Hello viewers, welcome back to this channel. This is Teacher Manasa as usual, and it's a learning time where we are going to have a lesson of mathematics. Specifically, we are still talking about the interest. You remember last time when we were together, we looked at simple interest, how is it calculated. We even saw how to get the amount. Remember, we said the simple interest is the profit or the gain we get after investing our money on a saving bank account for a certain length of time, and that principle does not change over that agreed time, and the rate of interest does not also change. Now, let's have a small review. We recall what we saw, then we move on. So, as you can see on the chalkboard, they are telling us to complete the table below. Here we have the column of principal, that of rate, time, simple interest, and the amount. We are given as A, the principal of 60,000 francs, the rate is 5%, and the interest should be calculated after 3 years. Now, B, we have 100,000 francs, rate 2%, time 5 years. Now we have to look at simple interest and the amount. My dear friends, remember we have the formula that we have to use. We say it that the simple interest is principal times rate times time. This is the formula we use to calculate the simple interest. And our amount, we saw that amount by formula equals principal plus simple interest in this case, because we are talking about the simple interest. Now, let's use this formula and we calculate the simple interest and the amount on both examples. Having number one or A, given that as we have the principal as 60,000 francs, we have our rate as 5%, we have our time as 3 years. Now, using this formula, we know that simple interest becomes 60,000 francs times 5%, that is 5 over 100. Remember, we said 5% means 5 over 100 in a form of fraction, times 3 as our time. We can now simplify by cancelling these zeros up and down together. This is 30 times 3, it's 90. Plus, adding our two zeros, we get 90,000. This is our simple interest after 3 years, when 60,000 francs are invested on an interest rate of 5%. Now, our simple interest, 90,000 francs, we need our amount, which we said that is simply equal to principal plus our simple interest. This is to mean that we are having 60,000 francs as our principal plus 90,000 francs as our simple interest, and our amount becomes
69,000 francs.
Dear friends, here we are using francs, but you can even use dollars and any type of currency that you are using. Taking example number two as B, let's have given that as,
we have a principal 100,000 as given. Our rate this time is 2%, and time becomes 5 years. So the simple interest, as we saw as formula,
is the principal times the rate times time. Now
is 100,000 francs times rate 2/100 times time 5 years.
We can also again simplify.
Zeros together.
Now this is 10 times 10, 100.
Adding our two zeros, we now have 10,000 francs. This is our simple
interest. Let's come back here and complete.
Our simple interest is 10,000 francs.
Now, amount,
as we saw, principal 100,000 plus our simple interest 10,000. So our amount simply becomes 1,110,000 francs.
Now this is what we saw last time. Now here, as you can see, we are now to calculate the rate. We are going to look at the rate. Still, we are not going far from what we have, because I want we prove whether what we are doing remains the same with no mistake. Finding the rate,
let's have now example number one.
We need the rate. I can take this table and I remove the rate and we now calculate it. Let's say,
as example number one, our principal, as we had it, 60,000 francs. Our time was 3 years. Now this time we are to have the simple interest, which is 9,000 francs. Now we find the rate of interest. It means that this person invested or borrowed 60,000 francs. He had to pay an interest of 9,000 francs after 3 years. We need the rate of interest. Now, by formula, we have to look at it. As we know, principal equals, simple interest equals principal times rate times time.
Now, we need to make our rate a subject. We go by dividing both sides by the same letters as to leave the rate on its own side. So I need to chase this P from this side. I chase even T from this side, so as to have the rate on its own. So to do so, as we have multiplication, we have to divide those values on both sides,
meaning that here I have to divide by P, our principal. I also divide it by time. This time when I cancel here, P has to go, P has to go. On this side, I have R, and it's what I want. But what I have done on this right side, I have to do it on the other side. I have to do it on the other side. So, here, dear friends, we have to know how to make this. We divided so as to chase this P and R from here. So I have to do it here, as I said, we have to do the same. I have my P, I also have my time. It means that my simple interest over principal times time becomes our rate. This is the formula. We now have rate as the formula of the rate. Using this formula, we are going to look at our rate and we see whether we are having 5%. Dear friends, after getting this formula, let's apply it in our question and we have our rate of interest. Our rate becomes our simple interest, 9,000 francs, over our principal, 60,000 francs, times time 3. Now let's simplify the zeros together. We again simplify these numbers. Here by 3, 1 by 3, 3. Now by 3 is 1, by 3 is 20. We have 1 over 20 as our rate. Now, you can say, is now that 5%? Yes, let's convert our fraction into percentages. 1 over 20 times 100%, we simplify. I remember we learned this. Simplify 0 by 0. We now have 2, 1 by 2, 5. We now have our 5%. So our rate of interest, which was 5%, is now calculated. Let's take example number 2. Our principal in example number 2 was 100,000 francs. Our time was 5 years, and we got a simple interest of 10,000 francs. So, using the same formula, our rate will be our simple interest, 10,000 francs, over our principal, 100,000 francs, times our time, 5. Let's simplify. We now have 1 over 50. Let's now convert this one as percentage. 1 over 50 times 100% by 5, 1 by 5, 2, we now have 2%. So, you can see that in our number one, we got our rate 5%, and it's what we were given before. In our example number two, we have got 2%, and it's what we had before. Dear viewers, you can see that after knowing the formula of getting the simple interest, we can also make for our own the formula of getting rate, as we got it here, and we applied this formula to prove that the rate we were given before are correct, are matching in these examples. Let's stop from here. We thank you very much for watching. See you next time.